Mitole. Good evening to you, gentlemen. Let's start with you. I mean, this is the day after confirmation, six people killed. What does this mean for the new dawn in Zimbabwe? Let's start it there.
This is a sad situation, a dark chapter on these elections. It was unexpected, unnecessary loss of lives. And we have to ensure that those who caused this are held accountable, both government and the opposition. Mm. But nonetheless, it will not stop the process and the continuous gradual democratization of Zimbabwe with the final release of results, which is part of the problem. I think there has been a delay, unnecessary delay, and you can see the hiccups, whether it's resources or anything. It's something that the observers, as we stand, we have 43 different sets of observers who are there, and we are waiting anxiously for them to release their reports. Some have done so and are waiting for others, and really follow up in terms of what happened, what went wrong, and what should be avoided in future.
Well, Mr. Mitole, we're talking here about the democratization of Zimbabwe. Some were talking earlier today about the increased securitization of Zimbabwe. How do you analyze what happened?
The securitization of the country is in tandem with the global trends, because Zimbabwe is not operating in an empty space. It is operating within the international community, within the international governance system. So it's a very sad chapter, especially looking at the background of loss of life, which is unnecessary, as Prof has just said. Nelson Chamisa comes across as a very combative young man, very full of confidence, brimming with the exuberance of youth. His prospect and a very promising young man. I think the large majority of the disenfranchised youth pinned their hopes on Nelson Chamisa. And with a parliamentary majority, I think ZANU-PF is guaranteed of a positive outcome in this election. So I would like to say that we saw this coming. Because remember that Zimbabwe is ruled by a military junta. And I think Nelson Chamisa was naive. I think his confidence and his arrogance borders on naivety. He's naive because he does not understand that a military junta is the one that put Mnangagwa there. And it is very highly unlikely that a military junta would allow someone coming outside of the ZANU-PF machinery to make it into government. The chances are very slim. Mm. So I can say with confidence that this is deja vu for the border politics.
This is very interesting, Dr. Monya, because earlier, after the coup, the soft coup, we saw scenes of civilians hugging army officials, and it seemed like something had changed. Was that just optics, and fundamentally nothing had changed?
Indeed, these were optics. We also have to understand that this wasn't a planned all-out killing of civilians. I think it was out of panic on part of the ZANU-PF.